man on your screens now is Alan Roscoff. He's a Sanders campaign delegate to the convention. You are listening to Elvis singing Trouble, because you're promising trouble at the convention, aren't you?
Well, we're promising.
Yes,
that
you are.
We're promising that our voices are going to be heard. We're promising that we're going to do everything we can to bring the Democratic Party back to its progressive roots. We're going to fight for health care, the single-payer health care plan. We're going to fight to end mass incarceration. We want to see to it that the 99% is represented and fought for. And we're going to have to do that by being forceful, by letting our presence be known. And
Okay, hold on a second.
Yes.
Forceful by letting our presence be known. That implies to me some deliberate disruption.
Well, we do not know yet what we're going to be doing, and the Sanders campaign is negotiating on issues and positions with the Clinton campaign. Who knows? We may walk out with everything we want or the vast majority of the issues that we care about, but we're skeptical that the establishment of the Democratic Party, they're likely to tell us to take a walk.
And but right now, forgive the expression, you're mad as hell, because you figure that the establishment stacked the rules against you at the convention.
The DNC has worked very hard against Bernie Sanders and against the principles.
And also, yesterday morning, before a single vote was cast in New Jersey or any place else, and certainly not in California, the New York Times and the Associated Press came out with a big headline and said, Hillary is the nominee. She's won.
Votes are taken, she's not the nominee.
But
anything can happen between now and then.
But it did have an effect on Bernie supporters in yesterday's primaries.
I'm sure.
Why should they turn out to vote when they know that they've already lost?
I'm sure that was a factor. It's always been a problem with polls coming out before the people vote, which discourages people from voting because they feel that it's a lost cause.
Yep.
I do want to say that no matter how we act out, if we act out, and how demanding we are, and how the progressive wing of the Democratic Party takes on the establishment, we're going to be united against Donald Trump. We're against racism.
Okay,
we're against.
Let me remind you of this.
Yes.
I'm old enough to remember the 1968 Chicago Democrat Convention. There was violence on the floor, and that resulted in the election of Richard Nixon. There was some disruption in the 1980 Democrat Convention, and Ronald Reagan won in a landslide thereafter. Are you worried that if you disrupt that convention from the left, you open the door to Donald Trump?
I do not believe we're going to disrupt what we're going to be doing, where we're going to be doing any favors to Donald Trump. We're a party united against racism and misogyny.
In 10 seconds, can you tell me what you think should be the top rate of federal income tax?
The top rate of federal income tax?
Yes.
Not sure, but I'd love to see Donald Trump's income tax returns.
You copped out.
Love to see him release his income tax returns.
You can't tell me the top rate of tax you think it should be?
Well, you're not addressing Donald Trump, not showing his income tax return.
I'm asking you a question. Can you tell me?
No.
What's the top rate of tax?
I'm not an economic major.
Okay. Alan Roscoff, thank you very much for joining us. We appreciate it. Thanks very much.
Thank you.